Welcome to Daniel Reviews. I'm Daniel Goodwin, and today we are looking at the Ecoflow Delta Pro Ultra, the big one. Let's get into it. I've made a lot of Ecoflow videos over the past 2 years or whatever, from the Delta Pro, the original Smart Home Panel, and a lot of things since. I've detailed a lot of good things and bad things along the way, and hopefully they've been helpful to you as well. That said, the product that I had been the most bullish on since I first started doing this was the Delta Pro Ultra, and I really wanted an opportunity to review it. It took a long time because I buy my own products. I don't get them shipped, most part, don't get anything shipped to me to do a review on. So this is just a, you know, I never presented myself as an expert. I don't want to say I'm an expert. I'm just an average person and sharing an average experience. That said, I have been running a Delta Pro Ultra for 2 months now, almost three. I wanted to wait to make this video because I felt like I discovered a lot of things with the original Delta Pros after I'd been using them for quite some time. And I wanted to have more experience with the Ultra before I did this video. So, like I said, I've been running this for almost three months. And I want to share my impressions. All right, so the Ultra inverter itself comes with this great carrying cart, which I don't have the instruction manual. I don't know if that was an oversight or what, but it's not here. But it's pretty simple to figure out. You simply screw in these casters to these holes in the frame, and then you know, shouldn't take too long to put together. So we'll do that now. Okay, to install, at first I thought I needed to use a wrench, but you really don't. You can just line them up, and then if you grab this little ring down at the bottom and twist that in, that's what will be successful. It's a little hard to do one-handed. Probably not the easiest to show here, but you can literally just grab it by this bottom ring and twist it, and it will go down. A little hard to do one-handed, but okay. So you do not have to use the little tray, but I strongly recommend it because this sucker is super heavy, but you put it on the casters and it's a lot easier to roll around, much easier than the original Delta Pros ever were, even though this is much heavier. On the side you have, here's your battery input from the inverter. You've got your power in and out. This would be to the Smart Home Panel. Then you got your high voltage PV input, which cool is MC4 connectors. That's interesting. I don't know if you can see that. Okay. And yep. So you got a cutoff switch here, and on. Don't really like how tight that sounded, but anyway, the other cool thing with these is they can slide in out of the way, so when you're connected, they're there, you can cover it up. How cool is that? I like that a lot. We are going to attach the Delta Pro inverter to the battery. It's a little hard to do one-handed. Heard it click. Should probably put this on the tripod. All right, we should be connected. Of course, it would not be an Ecoflow product if I didn't have to immediately do a firmware update. So holding my breath and hoping that will resolve the red light. Okay, I'm in the garage. Sorry, it's a little dark. It's winter. Lighting's not great. But I'll give you an overview of what I have. Here's my setup today. I still have two Delta Pros, the original Delta Pros over here, hooked up to the original Smart Home Panel. And these are all my split phase circuits. So my heat pump slash air conditioning, my wall oven, my electric range. I have a small den AC unit. All of those split phase units go through the Smart Home Panel, and these two Delta Pros power them. I found that is best because split phase draws evenly from both Delta Pro units. And so I don't have nearly the balancing issues with these two that I did when I tried to use two Delta Pros for my single phase side, where it would pull too much from one and not from the other, and it wouldn't alternate and things get out of whack all the time. The split phase just seems to work a lot better with the two Delta Pros. And then over here, I have the Smart Home Panel 2 that I detailed in a previous video, and I've been continuing to use it. I'll have a couple updates on some things with this that I want to call out, but for the most part, the experience has been very positive. It's been a good experience using the Smart Home Panel 2. It's worked relatively well. I haven't had any of those weird relays tripping. I can't remember, just a ton of things that happened with the other unit, but this one all worked pretty well. And what's powering it? Glad you asked. You can see it is a Delta Pro Ultra. Yeah. So this unit is fantastic. Compared to the Delta Pro, it's definitely got a much bigger footprint overall, but it uses it in a better way so that, honestly, it uses less of my garage than the Delta Pros do, particularly with extra batteries. What I have here is just the inverter, this top part, and then I have a battery down below for a total of 6 kilowatt hours of capacity. Why did I switch to a single Delta Pro Ultra versus the two Delta Pros I had powering this unit? A bunch of reasons. But number one, most of all, is that the balancing of two Delta Pros on a single phase was terrible. And it just didn't do a good job. One Delta Pro would get way low, you know, the other one would not. It wouldn't switch between them. It didn't draw down very well. They get out of balance all the time. And it just did not work very well running two Delta Pros into the dual voltage hub and into the Smart Home Panel. Switching to the Ultra has been fantastic because it's just one unit. The battery draws down evenly because it's providing all the power to the panel. And so when, you know, there's a surge or whatever, it handles it because it's got 7,200 watt output, which was just the same as the two Delta Pros essentially. And I just don't have any of the balancing problems. Now, the one weird issue that I have had is that sometimes, not very often, I would say probably about 4 times over the past 3 months, the Smart Home Panel just shuts off the battery power. Even though the unit's fully charged up, it's got 90%, 100% capacity, with nothing in the logs, no reason to said switch to grid, even though, you know, I have this on scheduled task and it should, you know, switch to the battery and run off the battery. I had times where it just doesn't. I don't know. It's like, nope, not feeling it today. So that part's kind of annoying that I've, you know, I have to check it on every single day and make sure that it actually is running off of battery power. Because sometimes it might just not, and it's honestly very easy to fix. You can even do it from the app. You just hit the power button on there and it will kick on the Delta Pro Ultra and start using it. But randomly, for no real reason that I can find in the logs or the messages, it just switches over to grid power. The only thing I can think of is that maybe my house single phase units are drawing more peak amperage than it can deliver, but that usually is logged and it says, you know, demand is too high. And that's not the case because honestly, I've never seen my single phase circuits draw more than like 2 kilowatts. Like the fact that it would exceed 7 and 7.2 kind of would blow my mind. I can't even imagine. Even though I was running the microwave and a space heater and I don't know what else I'd have to run to really the furnace at full speed. I just don't see it happening. So I don't think that's it. I think it's some sort of glitch in the software. Imagine that. Not Ecoflow. Otherwise, this has been pretty rock solid, and I don't have too many qualms about the Smart Home Panel and certainly not about the Delta Pro Ultra. It's working really well. Okay, you probably noticed that the Delta Pro Ultra has just one battery. That's 6 kilowatt hours of storage. That's not enough to really run a house, clearly. I had a whole video about how much it takes. Well, You might also know from my previous videos, I have an external battery bank that feeds into that Delta Pro Ultra along with solar power from a solar array. So the Delta Pro Ultra is getting solar power from, you know, an array, I forget what that is, probably 1600 watts, give or take. And then it also has, through two power switching power supplies, another 1600 watts coming in, so 3200. I could do more if I wanted more solar, but right now it's winter and I'm not gonna go mess with anything outside. But, so it's got plenty of power coming into it, and the biggest thing is I can use that external battery bank to extend the capacity of that Delta Pro Ultra. Right now I have an extra 10 kilowatt hours of battery storage flowing into it. It's wasteful, it's a little inefficient. I mentioned that. I'm not trying to argue that it's efficient, but it is affordable, right? I can add extra batteries to that external battery bank much more cost effectively than I could add extra batteries to the Delta Pro Ultra. Until that cost changes, I don't see adding more batteries to my Ultra. I will add batteries to my external battery bank because they're, you know, I can buy 5 kilowatt hours of battery capacity for $800 versus buying 6 kilowatt hours for $2,000. It's just not, you know, practical. Should probably talk about the app because the Delta Pro Ultra has a dramatically different interface than the original Delta Pro. And there's probably, well, I shouldn't say that. The Smart Home Panel 2 with the Delta Pro Ultra is a lot different from the original Delta Pro. The Delta Pro Ultra itself is pretty similar. So strike what I said. Okay. So here is the Ecoflow app, which still looks pretty much like it always has. Here's my units. I have the two Delta Pros that I've named the 240 volt, and then which I probably should call it 208 volt, whatever, it doesn't matter. And then I have the Delta Pro Ultra. So I'll click on the Delta Pro Ultra. You can see I'm getting power from both inputs. And so one's a solar array. I'm amazed I'm even getting 330 because we had 5 or 6 inches of snow yesterday, and I assume those panels would be under under that, but apparently not, so cool. And then I have 1.6 coming in essentially from the external battery bank, so pretty good input, certainly keeping up with my output, more than keeping up with my output on my house. The controls here are not very much different than before. You can adjust different things here. You know, electricity rate allows you to kind of calculate how much money you're saving based on your input. You also have your operating mode, but this is all overwritten because I have this hooked up to the Smart Home Panel 2, so it's not, you know, most of the things here I'm not using. There's a firmware update. I am so not doing that. Get me out of that. I'm closing it. I don't want that. No more firmware updates. We'll go back to them. And then, of course, you can turn on your DC output and things in here, but honestly, most of this is pretty similar. You can change the flow and look of the... why is it not letting me spin over for some reason? Oh, well. It's just how they present the data, but clearly that's pretty, you know, standard. What's nice is through the Smart Home Panel, I can see what is powering. When I talked about how sometimes it just simply won't switch to the Delta Pro battery, for some weird unexplained reason, you can just hit the power button here and it will in fact start using the battery. See how much your home is using. Obviously it's winter here and we just had snow, so I'm actually even surprised that we got battery power at all, or solar power to the batteries. But you can see how much the battery is using, how much we've used from the grid. This is just a much better overall interface versus the original Smart Home Panel. This is gives you a lot better detail into what your house's energy consumption looks like. So cool stuff. So in conclusion, I'm very pleased with the Delta Pro Ultra. It is a definite evolution on the product. It's been reliable for me. I haven't had any weird battery issues or balancing issues, but part of that is because I'm not trying to balance. There's one battery connected to the inverter, connected to the smart home panel. So there's not a lot of things to go wrong from that sense. And I'm powering it mostly through solar and an external battery bank, which I think is best. I get the functionality of the smart home panel in the Delta Pro, but I don't have to invest, you know, another mortgage payment loan into battery capacity. I can add to my external battery bank as I have the funds, and it will just flow into the Delta Pro Ultra. Yes, with some loss. Yes, with some inefficiency, but very efficient on your actual dollars. So I think it's a great way of utilizing the advantages of the Ecoflow system while minimizing some of the downside. Now, maybe it would be better just to go directly from my external controller into my grid and ignore and take out Ecoflow out of the system entirely. I don't think so. I'm not at that point yet. Had a lot of frustrations, but I'm not there yet. I like this hybrid selection or setup that I have at the moment. Hopefully this was interesting to you. If you have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Please click the subscribe button. I'll be producing a lot more videos and giving updates on all of the Ecoflow products that I have. Until next time, thanks for watching.